Hi and welcome to this edition of Out of the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the new Ubiquiti AI Theta. An interesting concept. Going to be interesting to see how this catches on. But let me show you what's in the box first, and then we'll maybe try and figure out how it all goes together. So you're going to get the main brains of the unit. I'll have a look at that in a moment. All right, you are going to get a Get Started guide. It's also going to remind you on the other side that this is a PoE powered device, no PoE injector or anything in the box. So do remember you will need that extra. You're also going to get a little drilling guide so you know how to mount the holding bracket. The holding bracket is this. This is for your brains of the operation. The idea obviously being that once that's fixed to the wall, you can then bring that into place like that and it's going to hold into place. Right, so we will have a look at that in a moment because I'm going to now use the release tool, which I'll show you in a moment, how to take the plate off at the back. You are going to get the two cameras, so you get interchangeable cameras. You get this one here, 8 megapixel, much more like a G4 bullet, and this one here, a 12 megapixel. 180 degree view. So this one here is about between 97 and 100 degree view. This one's 180, so essentially a fisheye that we're having a look at. So this is much more like the AI 360. This is more like your G4 bullet. As you can see, these are tiny. There's no infrared connectors or LEDs on here. So these are going to be really for inside surveillance, conference rooms, those type of things. I will just show you these. So you get your connector on the back there. As you can see, pretty small in size. And that's what you get look at the front. All right, you will get a set of screws and lugs. You'll also get your quick release tool, which we will use in a moment. You will also get the mounting housing that you are going to push your little camera into, that I can show you there. It's got a level with it as well. And you're going to get the ring that, again, you're going to put on. So what's the idea? You're going to drill a 22 mil hole, I think it is. You're going to put your camera inside here, which I'll show you how it goes. Push this up into the ceiling. There's a little bit of tape there that can be removed off for a little bit of sticky. Push it up on the other side of your false ceiling and spin this into place. All right, and that's going to clamp down on your ceiling or your gyprock or whatever you've got there and hold the whole camera into place. You're going to get one more thing on here, which is your cable. All right, and your cable will connect all of your devices, well, the devices together. So let me just show you pretty much how this all goes together. First, what I'm going to do is just show you the actual device itself. Once I've taken it out of this, I'm just going to take out the quick release tool here. Hopefully from its packaging, there we go. All right, so I have mounted the plate on the back there. I'm just going to push this tool in here to release it, and that will allow the plate to come off. So let's actually have a look at the brains itself. So let me hold that up. You've got an LCD screen here. On this LCD screen, it's going to show you the camera that's connected, and it's going to show you the audio symbol as well. Now, the cameras don't have a microphone or a speaker with them. There is, do look at the other video we've done, you do get an optional pack that you add to this. Pretty much this is like what's being used for the doorbell chime. So this is a microphone and speaker. So we'll show you how that is. So on the back here, here's our bracket. You can see our holes here that we have that our holding plate went into. At this side here, we've got our green connector. Our green connector is going to go to our camera of choice. And over this side here, it's going to go out if we have the optional audio module. Over here, we have our reset switch and our PoE in there. All right, so like I said, this is totally PoE powered. So let's take one of our cameras. Let's take our 360 camera here. We're going to pop out the tube that was in the middle there. So we've taken that out. We can see in here there's a very thin little rule coming, line coming in here. We can push here the camera into place. All right, and the camera is now securely connected into place there. Like we said, that's going to then have your fitting put in place and going to fit it to the wall. or the ceiling. We're then going to take our connector cable, conveniently got a purple connector to remind you it only fits one way round. We're going to fit the purple connector in here, and when you do it, the camera comes out the other end. So let me put my finger over that so it doesn't come out, push that in. All right, our cable obviously is through the other side of the wall. We are now going to clip that into place into our device here. And here is now our setup. Obviously, like I said, it's not going to work outdoors. This is more indoor for surveillance. This maybe is going to go over the top of some tills, point of sales. Maybe it's going to go in a conference room, anywhere we want slightly more discreet surveillance. There's no microphone built into this, no infrared built into this, no speaker built into this. So you will need the add-on audio module, like I said, that will plug into this side here, which will give you those bits. It'll be interesting to see what we come up with applications for this as Ubiquiti moves forward. I believe there's going to be some other options. I have seen some options in some of their promo about being able to people count and other things that this could be used for. So it'll be interesting to see as we move forward in the smart detections and the software that's being developed for it. So hopefully this has been useful, having a look at the Ubiquiti AI Theta. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. Loads more box openings on wireless network and firewall devices. We've got some guides on how to set up UniFi Protect or UniFi Network. So do head on over there, subscribe and stay up to date.